I'm fired up and I'm ready to go. I'm fired up and I'm ready to go. I'm fired up and I'm ready to go.
This is the Billionaire Brand Experience. Let's go.
Oh, so you, there was a point where you was like, hey, I'm just going to be big. I'm going to be overweight my whole life and I'm cool with it.
Yeah, and I'll tell you, I'll take you back to 2000 when I actually went under the knife. I did it drastically, okay? I had a failed, well, I shouldn't say, I don't know if I should say failed. I had a gastric bypass surgery where I lost over 120 pounds, okay?
Wow.
So that was drastic. That was life altering. That was being, I see it a lot. I see that people don't even make it as far as I've made it 17 years later to even still be here. And it's not so much as the surgery as much as it is the complications of the surgery, such as, you know, infection, you know, not healing properly, not getting the vital nutrients that is essential for you to continue to progress in your life as far as with your stomach being stapled and be, you know, having that surgery is drastic, seriously. But I went that measure, I went to the next level and I had that surgery back in 2000 and I lost the weight, but I didn't get as low as I am right now today. So I said, you know what? I'm healthy. I'm obese, but I'm healthy. I didn't have high blood pressure. I didn't have diabetes. I didn't have any health concerns other than being morbidly obese is what they would call it prior to my surgery, right? So I was obese, but other than that, I didn't have any other concerns. So I said, you know what? Maybe I'm just going to be on the thick side of the church. You know? this cute smile, you know, and I walk with a smile. Like, too, you don't know, sometimes subconsciously you could walk with that smile, and then when I get home, this is true now, when I get home and close that door, the emptiness, the loneliness, the unworthiness, the you're not enough, you're not good enough, you'll never be enough. You know, you're fat and you're walking with a smile and people laugh because you make a lot of jokes. All that is a cover up. All that is a facade that people don't realize. And I didn't even realize it. I was doing it. I was that one.
Wow.
Because, you know, you just don't never know. You never know. That's one thing, too, I like about being a life coach. And that where I get the name coach from, we didn't even talk about that. But I get the name coach because I went to life coaching school. And, you know, being that I'm a nurse for over 20 plus years, I have a bachelor's degree in nursing. Then, you know, I could talk to you about health, right? So that's where the name life and health coach came from. Life coach LaKesha, that's where the coach part of it came from. Carrie George, our mutual friend.
Yeah. Actually,
when I was going to coaching school, he was like, oh, well, we're going to call you coach. I'm like, coach, like coach. And I have people all the time. It's funny. I have people all the time that's like, well, what you coach? Like, you know, I'm like, I'm almost 300 pounds. You think I'm coaching the ball game?
But okay, so I just got caught up. So shout out to if Carrie does listen to this, shout out to Mr. Excitement. He's definitely an inspiration and motivating guy. I wanted to also let me get into so you said you didn't have any cases of diabetes, you didn't have any cases of blood pressure and none of that?
Okay, so originally I didn't have any of those things. So because I didn't have any of those things, that wasn't a preference for me. So that was when I decided, you know what, I'm gonna be 200 pounds and this is just who I am and this is just my life. You know, I just decided, okay, I'm just gonna settle for this. I'm okay, I'm still doing whatever I wanna do in life. But then September of 2016 was when it all shifted. And that is what brought me to today, where I am today. So September 2016, I went to Jamaica and I was sitting on the beach. My stepchildren had a birthday party and I went to give them to Jamaica to give them a birthday party. And so we went to the beach and they drew a heart in the sand. And in that, they were saying, like, we love you. And they wrote their names and all that. Well, I looked back at those pictures and I was like, oh my God, like, for real, I look like a baby whale. aside from that, Billionaire Brown, I went to my doctor for my annual physical. At that point, everything changed because instead of just being obese, now my doctor is saying to me, oh, your blood pressure is high, your cholesterol. Well, she didn't say that right at the moment, but she said your blood pressure is high. And I was like, oh, it's the Atlanta traffic. My blood pressure is normal. We're going to recheck it. I'm okay. Don't give me no pills.
You really said the Atlanta traffic?
Yeah, because...
Oh, my gosh. Keep going.
No. Seriously, I was late for work that day going to this appointment. So I knew my blood pressure was elevated because it's a wreck right on 285.
Oh, my gosh.
Traffic with anxiety based on the fact that I had a doctor's appointment scheduled for a certain time. I was going to be scheduled to go to work at a certain time, and I wasn't going to make it based on the traffic. So really, honestly, I really believe that the traffic had something to do with that. So I get in there, and I was like, we're going to recheck my blood pressure at the end of this appointment. Well, we rechecked it, and it was still the same. So at that point, I begged her. I said, you know what? I've made a shift in my thought process around food. I said, so I'll stop eating certain things. So just give me a minute. And I literally begged my doctor for 90 days. So this was my annual physical. I wouldn't have to go back until the next year. But because I had a problem, I had a condition at that time, I rescheduled that 90 days. I went back in and I wasn't faced with the Atlanta traffic. And I get there and my pressure is even higher. I'm like, oh my God, like, this is a problem. And so at that point, she got my blood work back. So my cholesterol was elevated. My blood pressure was elevated. So I'm a nurse and I know better, right? So I'm like, you know what? She was telling me all this stuff. Oh, well, you know, you can have a stroke. And I'm like, yeah, I'm a nurse doctor, you know. But however, so I accepted the pills. I accepted the blood pressure pills. So now I'm not only obese, now I'm hypertensive. Now I have hypercholesterol. You know, my cholesterol level is elevated. I know that I'm not eating properly because if it's, you know, anything that's good and greasy and fried and sweet, that's for me. That's what I want, right? I want the grease running down my arm. But I, you know, I felt like I didn't have a problem with food. I did have a problem with food, but this is honestly how I felt. So fast forward, the next 90 days, I continued on my journey of eating more healthy and making better choices. And with that, I had to learn how to give up something for something because I'm a real foodie. And I like my Lay's potato chips. I like my honey buns. I like my Oreos. I like my red velvet cake, my pumpkin pie, all those things, right? So I knew that I had to make a shift in my mind because I went drastic in 2000 and had this gastric bypass surgery. Well, gastric bypass tapers your stomach. It doesn't taper your mouth or your mind. So with that being the case, I still was eating those things that was satisfying me. And you might not know, billionaire, but women are emotional. And as it relates to food, we eat for comfort. We eat because, you know, I'm divorced or my boyfriend didn't call me or, you know, he canceled on the date or whatever the case is. And we eat for comfort. We eat and then we feel miserable afterwards. But in that moment, it's satisfying a need. It's satisfying a desire that we have that's internal. So I went ahead and I started continuing on my journey. Then I started to implement my products that I carry. Once I started to really implement the products in the next 90 days, I went back to the doctor. Excuse me. And the doctor said, oh, your blood pressure medicine is working very well. But the thing that I'd done, I'm looking around for now, my blood pressure machine, I don't have it right here. But what I did was I went to Walgreens. I bought a blood pressure machine that would save the different blood pressure readings, over 200. So I started to watch myself and monitor myself on a daily basis. So what I did was I started with one of the supplements that I carry for my company. And when I started with that supplement, over a 7-day time frame, my blood pressure began to normalize. Although I was taking the blood pressure pills, it wasn't going any higher, but it wasn't getting any better either. Does that make sense?
Absolutely.
Yes. So it was controlling it, but it wasn't necessarily regulating it. It wasn't making it better. It wasn't fixing the problem. It was masking. It was just enough to make it be normal or within a certain range, but it wasn't fixing it. So I started again on my product and I watched it 7 days and I took my videos on live. I mean, I did it live so people can really see, hey, I'm taking this and this is what my results are. Because you can't fake live. Like, you can fake a video and go back and edit it. You can't fake live, right? You can't fake live. I mean, not that I would want to, but people, they think for whatever reason that we got a lot of time and that we just make up stuff. But however, so my doctor, when I went back, she was like, oh, your numbers are so much better. That medicine is really working. And I said, yeah, it's working. It's on my microwave. She said, what do you mean? I said, I stopped taking that once my blood pressure got back normal because I don't want the side effects of medicine. Now, I'm not against medicine. We need medicine, you know, but it's certain things that could fix the problem and it's certain things that could cover up the problem. And I don't want to get into all that with the FDA, but the whole thing is
mind over medicine, right?
Right. Okay. The whole thing is, we could do certain things as, you know, to help ourselves, if you will. Like, we could stop eating, you know, the pork. We could stop eating the fried food. We could stop eating the sugar. We could do certain things, but it's not easy. You really have to make that mental shift in your mind to say that, look, this sugar is not going to be the death of me. Or this, you know, fried food is not going to be the death of me. Yeah, I might have my fried fish and grits. That's a Southern thing, Billionaire Brown.
Oh, yeah.
I might have to have my fried fish every now and then. When I go to Red Lobster, which was once in 2017, I'm going to have a Cheddar Bay biscuit. But I'm not going to have a Cheddar Bay biscuit every day. They have it in Walmart now. You can buy it and make it for yourself. No, I'm not making that in my house.
All right. So the products that you're talking about, what's the name of the products?
Our products.
Is it the ISO? The ISO.
Yes,
all right. I'm going to ask you a couple questions about it in a second. Okay. But I do want to know, how much is gastric surgery, or did your insurance cover it?
Okay, so at that time, I only had to pay a $50 copay, and that was only for a private
$50?
Room. I paid $50. That was only for the private room. If I was in a semi-private room, I wouldn't have to pay anything. But that
for
surgery
gastric
cost,
surgery?
Yeah, no, my insurance paid all but the $50 is what I'm saying.
Oh.
So it cost right at $30,000.
Wow. And okay. But your insurance covered that.
My insurance covered that. Mm-hmm.
That's not considered cosmetic?
No. If you are 300 pounds, whatever. I mean, no, it's something that's considered really life-threatening.
Okay.
Morbid obesity is life-threatening.
I never knew that. Now, the other question I wanted to ask you in regards to this gastric surgery is how you said when you did it, it took off 120 pounds, correct?
Right.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So when it took off 120 pounds, did you put any of that weight back on?
Absolutely.
Of that 120 did you put back on?
I would say at least about 50.
Excellent. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was where I was going with the point that you have to still shift your mind. No matter what, the surgery should have done or did what it was supposed to do. But then because I didn't do the internal work, I didn't do the mindset.